So again, talking with our producer, if you could update me one more time, if we know exactly where he's at or where he was last. I know he was near Sycamore in Leawood. So if you're familiar with that area or people in this neighborhood, give them a heads up. I believe we just saw another police cruiser, at least somewhat near him. But again, the difficult thing here is to actually stop this guy. They're going to have to get involved, and they don't want to add to any of this erratic driving. They don't want to develop this high-speed chase that could end up bringing them back onto the highways. Again, this is the closest look we've seen into this car, but you can definitely see the guy in the driver's seat, and you don't really see that same image from the passenger seat. So it appears that he might be alone. We haven't seen anybody else get out of that car either when he makes his stops and runs out. But yeah, you can see him just spinning that wheel, driving extremely erratically. Now it seems that he's on a side road again, one of those snow-covered roads, making things very dangerous for him as he continues to travel at high rates of speed on roads that aren't cleared yet, because these are the roads that often, snow crews can't get to. Okay, an updated location here, 132nd and Winoga is where this, and yeah, nobody in that passenger seat. 132nd and Winoga, you can see this man in a gray, what appears to be hoodie, driving this white Nissan pickup. Man, just driving erratically. I don't know if that was some type of creek, some type of small terrain, but he went right over it. Again, 132nd in Winoga is the latest update on his location. It's been kind of tough to keep up with him because he's been traveling just in circles and loops. So in order to get a precise location, we have to really check before we let you know where exactly he's at. But there's another truck that seems to have pulled over. So that's the thing. We've also, now it seems this might even be some type of shopping center or business offices, commercial retail space, but something there. Definitely, he's working his way out of that residential neighborhood area. So we'll see what he does here. But again, yes, he's going down the wrong way on this one-way highway. So this is a man in a white Nissan pickup that police are after. We don't know what they want him for, what he is wanted for, but he has been leading them on a chase for the past 50 minutes since 10:40. This began at 57th and Wayne. Last update was at 132nd in Winoga. He's now back onto the main roads. Not clear. Is this traveling? Do we know if this is traveling northbound, southbound? We aren't sure right now. We're trying to get a gauge of exactly where he's at. But yeah, oh man. As you can see, he's braking a little bit when he encounters more and more traffic. And as I mentioned, this traffic is only going to build up as we get closer to that lunch hour. But a scary situation for people traveling on this roadway because out of nowhere, this car comes and is just facing them head on. He has shown no signs of slowing down. He has shown no signs of being courteous on the roads in any matter because he keeps driving in those snow-covered roads and in people's backyards, through their landscaping, through their driveways, even getting out of his car and running in. Okay, even getting out of his car and running toward the houses. Latest update, 135th and State Line is where he's traveling. So 135th and State Line just made a right onto this strip of highway. You could see this is at least traveling in the correct direction based off of those arrows in the turning lane that you can see. But often, I mean, he's traveling in the completely wrong direction as well, which, for this to be going on now for 50 minutes and not lead to an accident really is just a miracle. We can only hope that it stays that way and that police stop this before it happens. But if you're just joining us, we do want to update you on everything we know, which, to be completely honest with you, isn't much just based off of the fact that police need to stick with this guy and try and get him before they update us on what he's wanted for. So we don't know what he's wanted for, but we do know that on this chase, he has hit a police cruiser. An officer was in it. We don't know if that officer is hurt. He could be fine, but we know that he has struck a cruiser. And this is something that we've seen from him time and time again, going through backyards, going through these grassy covered areas, all to lead police on this chase that's making it very difficult for them to stop him. The more intricate neighborhoods he goes through and the more backyards he goes through is obviously making the police officer's job more difficult and bringing him to a stop. Again, this is 135th and State Line, at least in that general area. This has to be the third, fourth neighborhood maybe we've seen him going through. So it isn't all the same neighborhoods. Multiple people are going to, you know, end up today saying, yeah, I saw this guy in a white pickup speeding through my neighborhood, because he just keeps hopping from neighborhood to neighborhood. Again, taking each turn extremely fast. You try to gauge how fast he is going. As he's working through these neighborhoods, it's a lot slower. But you can see right here, he picks up speed each time he gets on a main road. This is 144th and Kenneth now. Traveling extremely fast, 144th and Kenneth. This man in the white Nissan pickup, when Chopper 5 zooms in, you can see there's nobody in the passenger seat. You just see him in that, he's wearing a gray hoodie. People on that roadway, as you could see, slowed down and braked, rather than just getting out of the way, and it forced him to then get out of the way and travel on the grassy area again, the snow-covered area. He's managed to find his way back on the road. This is near 144th and Kenneth. Yeah, showing no signs of slowing down. And again, this began at 10:40, so here we are at 11:35. And he has been leading police on this chase all over the city. Here we are on these main roads again. The benefit to him sticking on these main roads would be that they aren't snow covered, because crews have worked so hard over the weekend to clear them. But anytime he gets in those grassy areas, anytime he's in those neighborhoods, you do see those roads that are going to be tricky. And this is northbound State Line near 151 Highway. If you put that in perspective of where he was at 57th and Wayne when he began this chase, it just shows how long of a chase this has been and how many areas he has led police through, in backyards and shopping centers, commercial retail spaces, what we saw him take them through a bit ago through a parking lot. But definitely a dangerous situation when you think about just how many people are out on the roads today. It's the Tuesday before Christmas shopping, you know, lots of people doing that, lots of people taking their lunch breaks right around this hour. So we got to hope that police find a way to stop this soon, but they've been wanting to keep their distance because of just how dangerous this could be if they send many cruisers after him, or if they travel at the same speed as him. That's just adding to the amount of cars that could, you know, get in the way of drivers who are innocent, who are obeying the rules of the road. So often in these cases, they will, you know, follow from above with their chopper, just as Chopper 5 is doing right now. And here he is about to, he's making his way into that, the other side of traffic, in order to pass cars that are slowing him down in his path. You would think he has to be going 50, 60 miles an hour on these roads that likely aren't even that speed limit to begin with. So bringing you up to speed again, a white Nissan pickup. This man inside, we aren't sure what he's wanted for. We're working and making calls to figure that out. But as you can imagine, police have their hands tied trying to stop him before they're going to update us on what he could be wanted for. Okay. And we're just learning that KCTV5's Ellen McNamara is in that area. And Ellen, can you hear me?
Yeah, hey Joe. Yeah,
Ellen, so I know you saw the chase. So kind of update us as we watch him, what he's doing. He's getting out of control, as you can imagine, but update us on what you saw from Lee Wood.
Yeah, so I was on the ground, Joe, and I was in my car just driving through my neighborhood in Lee Wood near the Country Club of Lee Wood. So there's a huge golf course. We're near 128th and State Line.
Okay.
And I was driving just on some streets, you know, just residential streets. And I don't know, about three police cars zipped through the area, were zooming by, and then the police helicopter was overhead. So I'm assuming at that point that man who was trying to get away was in a backyard because he was on the residential area. So they zip by me. The police chopper was above, and they continue to follow the person on the ground.
And it seems like they're using that helicopter just to ease the situation a bit on the roadways, because this man is just driving so erratically. They don't want to add to that stress and that erratic behavior on the roads.
Yeah, and the police cars that zipped by me pretty fast, they didn't even have their lights on.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm assuming that was just because they're going through a pretty heavy residential area. So just did you, you know, to be a little bit safer.
Yeah. Did you see the white pickup at all, or did you only see the,
the
cruisers?
No, I didn't, but I knew something was going on immediately when the police cars drove by me, and then I could see the helicopter above. So again, I believe at that point that truck was in a backyard because I was on kind of the front side of the road, and I believe he was in the backyard at that point.
Okay. Yeah. And so, he's been going through lots and lots of backyards and lots of neighborhoods. We believe he's on 150 highway right now on the Missouri side. So you can see just how far he's traveled because you saw him back in Leawood, correct?
Yeah. So we are, again, we're near like 135th state line, 128. And there's a golf course around here and quite a bit of land. But yeah, he's obviously making up quite a lot of ground if he's gotten from there. And honestly, so I'm standing on this golf course right now, and the police helicopter has moved out of the neighborhood. So I don't even see that anymore. So yeah, he definitely must have covered some ground pretty quickly and is out of this area now.
Yeah.
And again, it's near 135th and state line.
Okay, well, good to know. We're glad that that you're safe and that you could kind of report back to us what you saw. The big takeaway from you is that you saw the cruisers, but you didn't see the truck, which just goes to show how far back they're staying. Right now, he's back on those highways going at an extremely high rate of speed. This might be the fastest that we've seen. Again, this is on 150 highway. Ellen, if you're still there, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. In your area, were people aware of what was going on? Was anybody coming out of their homes or on that golf course?
Yeah, so there was a almost like a party, like a get together with a bunch of women in the neighborhood, and so there were some women that were getting out of their cars who were kind of commenting, "Oh my gosh, you know what's going on?" Because they saw that the cops drive by, and they also saw the helicopter. So people didn't really know what on earth was going on, and to be honest, I mean, things like that don't really happen in this neighborhood. So I think people are kind of surprised as to what on earth was going on. But they seem to, you know, be startled a little bit, but, but obviously they knew that the police were doing their job.
Well, not only do they, you often don't see an activity like that, but you also don't see it at 11 a.m. and you don't see it, you know, in weather like this usually. So, that is making things tricky as well, trying to, you know, navigate this guy as he's going on this backyard frenzy covered in snow. I mean, it's not safe driving conditions for police to even try to chase him. But okay,
Ellen. Yeah. And I said, when you're talking about the snow, I'm standing again on this golf course and there's like 3 inches probably of snow, just, you know, just, it's kind of the thick.
Yeah.
The thick because it's there's moisture, it's starting to melt a little bit. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I mean, getting through a yard with a lot of snow like that is definitely a difficult task.
Yeah, difficult.
But if you're in a truck, it's going to be a little bit easier than a car.
Exactly, which is what has allowed this man to continue this chase now for going on almost an hour. Actually, we just hit the hour mark. So yeah, he's been going for quite some time, but difficult and dangerous for sure for police to try and catch this man. But we're going to stick with him as we kind of continue to follow where he's heading. Ellen, if you have any more updates for us, let us know. And if you see anything or if it wraps around back to Leawood, give us a call again. So we appreciate that. All right, Ellen.
Will do. All right. See you later.
Thank you. Okay, so that was Ellen McNamara here with KCTV5. She just happened to be in the area of that police chase. So she saw the cruisers coming near the white Nissan that is leading them on the chase, but it wasn't quite close enough to where she saw the truck as well. So that just proves that the officers are keeping their distance. And you think about why they're keeping their distance. One, they don't want to put any more people on the roadways in danger. You have one car traveling, as you can see, the wrong way down roads, going at high speeds. They don't want to do the same. But the other issue here is that they don't want to be traveling on the snow-covered roads. They don't want to be, you know, adding to the confusion in the neighborhood. So it's easier for these police officers often to track from above. Now, couple that all with the fact that this man has already hit a police cruiser. Sometime during this chase, he hit a police cruiser. We're working to learn the update on the officer. They may not even be hurt, but we know he hit their car. But that makes them want to stay back because they know what this man is now capable of when it comes to the chase. They know that he's not giving up easily. They know that he is not decreasing his rate of speed at any point, especially when he gets on these major roads. And they know that at times when he easily could be traveling the correct way down the roadway, he's almost choosing to travel this wrong direction. We've seen him more traveling the wrong direction than we have seen him traveling in the correct direction. And here just goes to prove that. We're working to figure out, this is near Grandview. So again, we've been all over the metro right now. 57th and Wayne, this began. Ellen McNamara saw him in Leawood. Police were in Leawood, 97th and Mission. Now we're up near Grandview. And this guy is showing no signs of slowing down. obviously a scary situation for people on the roadways, one that we hope does not turn tragic or turn into a crash or anything, but you can see just how many people he is putting at risk. I mean, just right there, he had to have passed 10 cars. So you got to hope that everybody is paying attention on the roadways in this area right now, because just any type of distraction could lead you to not see this truck. So we do know that the police helicopter is up and tracking him. Ellen McNamara told us she did see that helicopter, which we have assumed has been on top of him as well, because you haven't seen many police cruisers close to him. But they aren't letting him out of their sight. Okay, just getting another update. I-49 just south of Blue Ridge Boulevard. I-49 just south of Blue Ridge is where this truck is heading. And man, is it going fast. Pushing 70, most likely, on these streets that are not main highways. But you can see that they're kind of tight quarters back in these residential areas, too. He's slowing down a little bit to make this turn. And many people in these neighborhoods are going to think, what is going on? Because as Ellen mentioned, this isn't something that she's ever seen in that area, something that you don't see anywhere really at 11:45 in the morning. And this has been going on since 10:45 in the morning. So lots of people, of course, are wondering what is happening. And police are trying to do the same, because right now it's not clear what he's wanted for. So we're still working to figure that out. What did this guy do that is making police want him? And then what did he do that's making him not want to surrender? And those right there, that's an example of the street still covered in snow that he has been driving on. Many tricky areas for him to navigate around, but as Ellen mentioned, it's a little easier to do in a pickup truck like this. You can imagine what this would be like if he was in a car. Certainly, he wouldn't be getting around that heavy terrain, the snow, the backyards, the landscaping. We've seen him hopping curbs. For him to continue on this path at this high speeds, driving that erratically, it goes to show that he is able to do this in part because of the vehicle that he is in. So I'm trying to see right now if that pickup at the bottom of the screen, that does look to be an officer. If you look at the top, you can kind of, yep, that's definitely a police vehicle. So we can see that they are probably about, 50 yards back from him. Those cars right there pulled off to the side. They must have been paying attention and seeing what was happening down just a bit ahead of them. But they pulled off to the side, which is the smartest move you can make. Again, this is near Grandview, I believe. Our producer is in the booth right now trying to work to figure out where. But if you know anybody traveling in this area, if you know anybody that works in this area that might be heading off to take a lunch break, you might want to tell them to just stay in. You don't want to be driving on the roads with somebody like this at the wheel, especially with him going down, the wrong way of these roads. Just any distraction would lead him to hitting a vehicle head on. And there is a police car. So now we've seen a cruiser and a what looked to be more of a SUV style police car. So we know that there are multiple people on him. We know the helicopter is tracing him from above. And again, it's been about 20 minutes since we've seen him in a neighborhood, but he is back. So this seems to be, he's taking his chase now through a neighborhood again. And just counting the neighborhoods that we have been following since we've got on the air with this, this has to be the fifth neighborhood that he has entered. Going over curbs like you've seen there, going through people's yards. Thankfully, the weather is chilly, it's cold. There's no reason really for people to be outside in their neighborhoods, but you got to be thankful that this isn't happening on a hot summer day, because just imagine how many people would be out and about in the neighborhood. Here he is going through more backyards, that heavy terrain. You can see these roads are snow covered. It even looked like the backside of his truck is kind of spun out there at the end. And this is a heavily wooded area. This is the first time we've seen him traveling through something like that. Back into what appears to be more of an open field, looking for a shortcut onto the roadways. So if you're just joining us, we want to tell you everything we know. It's a white Nissan pickup near Grandview, but this has been all over the metro. He's been in Leawood. It started at 57th and Wayne. This pretty much sums up what he's been doing. He travels on these highways, on these main roads, going at the high rate of speed, and then he's been looking to evade police by going through people's backyards. So not only is he creating dangerous situations on the roads, but then in people's homes, because these people could be, you know, taking their trash out, going to get the mail, and all of a sudden he's going to pull up on their driveway. We've seen him twice now get out of his car. That was about a half hour ago, though. So we've seen him get out of the car and try to run, but he quickly gets back in. Clearly, he's decided that the best way to try to evade police is by staying in his vehicle. His truck is certainly helping him make it through this terrain, because I know many cars would not be able to make it through that snow. You could even see he's retracing his steps. You saw his tire tracks in the snow right there. So he's been on this road before. This is near Hillcrest and 470. We're seeing police out of their cars right there. They blocked off that roadway. We saw two cruisers with their lights on. Police seemed to be out of their cars. I can't make out close enough to see what they were doing, but it did seem like they had that they were out and making an attempt to stop him. I don't know if guns were drawn there, but they were definitely leaning towards him. They had two cruisers pulled off on those side streets. I would think that now, in addition to chasing him, their goal is to keep people away from him as much as they can. So blocking off those streets is going to help them in the end and help keep you safe in the end as well. But yeah, he is just showing no signs of stopping right now. Back onto those snow-covered streets. The only time he really slows down is when he goes to make those tight turns, because I think he's aware that with these tricky roads, he will spin out. But we are now more than an hour into this chase. It's been going on for an hour and 10 minutes. It began at 10:40 this morning at 57th and Wayne in Kansas City, Missouri. It has reached all areas of the metro, going through Leawood, 97th and Mission. We've been talking with Ellen McNamara, who was in Leawood, giving us an idea of what was going on in the ground there. She said people got out of their cars. They were confused. What's happening? They saw police cruisers speeding by, something you certainly don't see at this time of the day. She saw the police helicopter up from above, but it was short-lived because this man has been traveling at such high speeds and going such long distances that he's really been all over the area, making it difficult for police to put a stop to it. He's not staying in one contained area where they can just put those stop sticks down or put those stop strips down. Okay. So another update from Ellen McNamara. Not only are we going through homes, not only are we going through roads and main roads and what looked to be like commercial or retail space, but Ellen also says he also took his truck onto the Country Club of Leawood's golf course. So he also did some damage there, driving around on the golf course. And that's where Ellen spoke with us. We did a quick phone interview with her about what she saw, and she said that it was definitely a scary situation. People got out of their cars not knowing what was going on. But perhaps it's more scary for the people right now on these major highways. The good news, not that there is any good news about this, but he's traveling the correct way down the road, which for the majority of this chase, he has been going the complete opposite direction of traffic, making it extremely dangerous and extremely likely that it could lead to a head-on crash. So this, you can see, he's more navigating around cars rather than having cars get out of his way. But he is sticking on this main road right now, westbound on Red Ridge right now. This is west of 49 Highway. So westbound on Red Ridge, west of 49 Highway. And this is about the closest look that we've gotten at this man. We don't know much about him besides that he's wearing a gray sweatshirt. We do know that there's nobody in the passenger seat. I can't speak to if there's somebody in the back seat. However, it doesn't appear so, because at times this man has abandoned the car and gotten out and ran away and came back, and we have seen nobody else exit the vehicle. Extremely high speeds, though, here. It's tough to say just how fast, but you would think much over 80, maybe even pushing 100. He slowed down a little bit, and now he's back onto the going the opposite way of traffic. So you can see many cars are pulled over to the side if they're paying attention and can see him coming their way, but others just go right by him. And here we go, another truck that he just passed. So we haven't seen police cruisers or cars anywhere near him besides about 50 yards away is what my estimate would be the last time we saw a police cruiser. And that's because they need to keep their distance. You just saw there for yourself how dangerous this is and how high of a rate of speed he is going. And man, he is coming close to those cars when he passes them as well. But just look right now at your screen at how, and there's a police cruiser right behind him. But just look right now at your screen, how snow covered those yards are and how snow covered that grass is. It has not kept him or deterred him from traveling through it at all. And his truck is the main reason why he can do that, because if he was in a car, this chase, I would say it's safe to say it would have ended long ago. But here we are going on an hour and 20 minutes. This is just off of Montgomery and Redbridge in Kansas City, Missouri. So we're back to Casey Mill where this began at 57th and Wayne. Not the same area, but back in the city limits. And now he's going on a back road of some sort. I'm not even sure you could call this a road, but definitely in some terrain in a heavily wooded area. There's a roadway, but you can still see it's covered in snow. Not an easy situation to navigate, especially at the speeds that he is going. Here we are at what I would assume is an apartment complex, townhomes of some sort. You can see police or regular cars just parked along the way. Oh, he's out again. He is out. It seems that he didn't put. Did he just get? I believe he just tried to take another vehicle. He just carjacked somebody. So to the left, what you just saw is the truck that he was in. He just carjacked somebody taking a very similar looking truck. So this situation has just intensified right now. He is now putting people in direct danger by coming up to them and carjacking them, telling them to get out of the car. So this white pickup, to clear up any confusion, is a new white pickup. This is not the white Nissan anymore. He has carjacked somebody. You saw the man then get out of the car and not know what to do, but the car went away. It didn't appear that that man did get hurt, thankfully. But there's another man that just was in a roadway. And here you can see police officers throwing what I'm guessing are stop sticks. You can see trying to stop him in any way that they can. And it seems that they worked because he's spinning out a bit. I'm not sure if his tire blew or if he just lost control there. But just in the last 5 minutes, if you just turned us on or if you looked away from the screen, this situation has intensified. You can see police there, one diving onto the ground. He carjacked somebody just a bit ago, just within the last minute. So this is a new white pickup that he is driving erratically down the road, showing no signs of stopping. Police throwing stop sticks at him, them not working because it appears that he's still going and that he just lost control a bit ago. It appears his tires are still intact. He is still able to drive at these high rates of speed. But again, this situation has intensified because somebody has now been put in imminent danger when he came face to face with them and took them out of their car and stole it. He also left his car that he was in running. You saw it go off to the side there, off of the street. He didn't even bother to put it in park. So again, what just happened is that this chase that's now been going on for an hour and 20 minutes, this is the first time that we have seen him ditch his vehicle and hop into another vehicle that was being operated by somebody else. So he carjacked somebody. Add that to the list of things he's done so far. Carjacked somebody, been driving the wrong way down streets, pushing 100 miles an hour. He has hit a police cruiser at one point. We don't know the status of the officer that was in that cruiser. Again, that officer could very well be okay. But again, we just know that he has hit their police cruiser. We saw police just a bit ago trying to throw those stop sticks down. He didn't show any signs of slowing down as police were out of their vehicles coming near his truck. So that thankfully did not end poorly, but he was going at a high rate of speed as they were outside of their truck trying to stop him. We saw one officer have to dive and roll to the ground. But again, this is a new vehicle that he is in. It looks very similar. It almost looks the exact same to the vehicle that he was in. But no, he let his vehicle go. He hopped out. He jumped into a new one. Trying to get an update on where this could be right now, because during that situation where he carjacked somebody, we kind of lost control of where he could be. But at last check, he was in Kansas City, Missouri. And this chase, northbound on Blue River, headed toward 435. Again, northbound on Blue River, headed toward 435, excuse me, is where this chase is heading now. You can see one officer, one cruiser with their lights on. That's an SUV following closely behind him now. This is the most police action that we've gotten to see on the screen since this chase began. Most of the police action has been kept off your screen because they've been keeping their distance. They've been following from the helicopter above, and they've been staying 50 to 100 yards back from him. But now you can see they're up close and personal because I think they've realized that this guy is showing no signs of slowing down. Again, he is now in these back roads. It doesn't look like he's on a main road right now. We haven't seen much traffic, which is a good thing. And snow-covered roads again. Okay, now you can see right there. This is our first look at that front driver's tire, the driver's side tire. It's shredded. You can see the tire itself seems to be coming off the hubcap. He is spinning out when he makes those turns. So whatever they threw down, those stop sticks, that stop strip, it definitely worked because one of those tires has been punctured, which is keeping him from traveling any faster than he is right now, it seems. And if he pushes those high speed limits, my guess is that that tire will eventually come off. So this was all part of the police tactic to try to slow him down without putting more lives in danger. And here he is, he spun out, hitting some brush. That front wheel is really, and there it is, the tire is off. So the tire is off, he's now just driving on what would appear to be that hubcap. And this is in a vehicle that he carjacked from somebody. If you haven't followed along, completely understandable because this has been a very developing situation, one that's been tough to follow. But this vehicle, although it looks like the one he was originally in, is one that he carjacked from somebody. And right now, police are surrounding him. This is the closest police have gotten to him since this situation started. Now police are getting back in their vehicle because he is just pushing this as far as he can go. That car can't be going more than 5 miles an hour yet. He isn't giving up. Again, you can't see it, but the driver's side front wheel is off of that car. It also appears that the front bumper is hanging off as well. So there is some damage done to this car that it doesn't even belong to him. This was carjacked from somebody else. Blue River Road and Chestnut is where this is happening right now. Blue River Road and Chestnut, this is the slowest that we have seen him going since this began an hour and 20 minutes ago. Blue River and Chestnut is where he is at right now. The front bumper is off. The front tire on the driver's side is off. You can see him swerving, trying to control that car despite all of the implications that he's now working against. He is now at a complete stop. Reversing back onto the grass. Police are exiting their vehicles. I'm trying to get a closer look at police to see if they have guns drawn, to see if they have stop sticks in their hands. It's not clear. They do have guns drawn. We're told they do have guns drawn. So right now, he is trying to gather control of this vehicle, which just isn't going to happen. I mean, he's lost a wheel. So he is taking this to and pushing it to the final moments. But now the car is smoking. They have guns drawn surrounding him from the front side of that car. It's not clear right now if there are police on the back end as well, but we know that there are several police officers and cruisers on the front side of that car right now. It seems that he might even be stuck. Chestnut and Walrond is his current location. Trying to see if he's stuck, this might be police's chance to try to get up close to him because it appears that his car is having trouble navigating out of that grassy area. So take a look at your screen. This is the most police activity that we have seen. It looks to be three SUVs, one cruiser on the left side of your screen. That truck, which was carjacked, is now in the center of your screen, and he, again, is keeping this going. He's doing everything in his power he can to get that truck moving again, but as we've seen, police have thrown down the stop strips. They have punctured the tire of his driver's side front passenger wheel, the driver's side front wheel. That has been long gone, so he's now just driving on a hubcap on that side. He's lost a bumper. And in the situation we're in right now, it would be tough to imagine him coming and taking his truck elsewhere. Yep, he's out, hands up, he's on his knees. It appears this is police's chance, hands behind the back, and they've gone in. So it seems this chase that began at 10:40 has now ended with that driver laying face down in a field, hands behind his back, surrounded by multiple police officers, what appears to be SWAT team members. The police presence here is huge. And finally, it took an hour and 43 minutes from when we were first reporting that this started at 10:40 to get this man to surrender. Again, we do not know why this man led them on such a lengthy and dangerous chase. However, we do know that he put multiple lives in danger as he led them on the chase. Not only was he putting people in danger on the roadways as he went the wrong direction at high rates of speed, but he went through backyards, he went through driveways, he hit a police cruiser, and at the very end, around 11:40, that was about 20 minutes ago, he carjacked somebody. Here he is being walked to the police officer cruiser now, hands behind the back. Again, he was wearing that gray hoodie. By now, we would know if somebody else was in this truck. So clearly, nobody else was involved with this in terms of at least the chase portion. So here he is being walked to a police cruiser. Again, you can see police with their guns drawn. The man is wearing a gray hoodie, jeans, appears to be some type of boots. So this man, not sure what he's wanted for. We don't know who he is, but we do know that he led them on an hour and 23 minute long chase through multiple parts of the city. We know at one point, here's a closer look at him. This is the closest look that we've got since this began. And after all that we saw, the sporadic driving, the evasive driving, him trying to get away from police, we do have to say that aside from the carjacking, we saw this end peacefully because he got out of the car, hands up, immediately went down to the ground and put his hands on his behind his back. It is not clear what happened during that carjacking, if anybody was hurt, but we can tell you that the person that he carjacked was up and standing and did seem to walk away from what we could see from our vantage from Chopper 5. It seemed that that person was okay. Now you can see him getting put in the back of a police van, emptying his pockets right now, police searching him before they put him in there. But this ended after a lengthy and dangerous chase. It is unbelievable that after an hour and 20 minutes, he did not get in a crash with anybody on the roadways. So we can be very thankful for that. Also unbelievable that he didn't put anybody else in danger that might have been leaving their house or in their backyard, because he went through so many neighborhoods. I counted at least five, and we didn't start breaking in with coverage of this until about 20 minutes after it happened. We know that he had been on the Country Club of Leawood golf course, that he drove through some commercial and residential areas, that there was a shopping center that he went through. He was on major highways, backyards, in wooded areas. And it seems right now he is talking with police. He is up and he's coherent. And if you're just joining us, this was a man that was originally in a white Nissan pickup. He led police on this chase, not clear what he's wanted for, but in the span of an hour and 20 minutes, he carjacked somebody, he hit a police cruiser, he drove through driveways and backyards, through people's landscaping, up over curbs, and went the wrong way down major highways, pushing at least 100 miles an hour. Police right now have arrested him. If you didn't see the arrest happen on our air, you can know that it was a peaceful arrest. He immediately got out of the truck that he carjacked because he lost control of it. His tire blew after they threw down stop strips. So he lost control after that tire blew, and after he lost a bumper, went into a grassy area, and it seemed that he got stuck in that terrain. Ellen McNamara chimed in with us a bit because she saw this chase going down from Leawood, and she mentioned that the grass is giving a lot because the snow is melting. So that speaks to why that car stopped working. Imagine, you know, driving a car with just the hubcaps through grass like that. So that is what it took to finally get this man to stop after an hour and 20 minutes. Okay. So getting updates from my producer right now. We are continuing to follow this situation, giving you a much larger view of just how many police cruisers were involved. We've showed you the close-up of him being arrested. He's now in that van. But this is because we've stuck with him through that chase and because we wanted to give you the closest picture of him and where he was heading in order to keep you safe. We didn't zoom out at all, but this is our first look zoomed out at just how many people were involved in this chase. You could see that road right now is lined with police cruisers, police vans, police SUVs. And that goes to show just how many people were involved in this since it began at an hour and 20 minutes ago. Add to that the police helicopter. So we do want to recap. I know this has been very hard to follow as this develops because there's so much that went into this chase, but we want to give you the latest details from the very beginning. So here is video of when this chase happened. This is not live video. This is what we have been following. And this, I believe, is the carjacking. Right here is the carjacking. The suspect, that driver, stole another truck right here from a victim happening just a few minutes ago. This happened at Montgall in Redbridge. It was at an apartment complex. So that man was in a truck very similar to the one that the driver had originally. He gets out. You can see the carjacking happening right here. He takes that man's car. Not clear if that man was hurt, but we can see him standing, which is good news. We see the man standing right there. Just about 25 minutes ago, we saw the truck driving the wrong way on multiple roads in South Jackson County. Cars literally, if you were with us during this chase, you saw me trying to navigate this. They were having to veer out of the way and not get hit. Incredibly, we have not seen any collisions, incredibly and thankfully. No collisions have happened yet, but some very close calls during the hour and 20 minute long chase. Earlier, we also saw the truck driving through neighborhoods, going through backyards, going through driveways, especially the primary place that we saw him going through those major neighborhoods and major backyards was in Leawood. They cut through yards. At one point, he stopped near a house, even got out of the truck before he got back in. That really only lasted no more than 5 seconds. He got out of his truck, went toward a house, sprinted towards it, and we immediately saw him get back in. People were out as that truck drove through. So again, it's incredible that there were no injuries in the neighborhood. So no injuries on the roadways, no injuries in the neighborhoods. The only thing that is kind of up for debate right now is if that victim who was carjacked could be facing any injuries. But we did see him standing up in what seemed to be coherent. So that's good news. He also did hit a police cruiser at one point. So that too, we are working to learn if that officer sustained any injuries, but we haven't heard that he has yet. So right now we're still working to figure that out. But at one point during the chase, the truck passed cops. Their guns were drawn. That's what you see right here. So their guns were drawn as he passed them. Not clear if they took any shots at the tires or the truck itself. But here's slow motion video of that. You see the two cops to the side. Their guns are drawn as he makes their way past them. Didn't see any shots fired again. Police were doing their best to somehow bring it to a safe end, though, doing whatever they could. So we want to make sure to make this as easy as possible for you to understand. What is on the left is what happened throughout the chase. And if I'm recalling correctly, this was about halfway through the chase. That's on the left in the tiny box. The bigger, larger box is live pictures we're bringing you from Chopper 5. That is the police response after this has all wrapped up. You can see the cruisers on a side street of what appears to be some neighborhood with the suspect is in a van. Yeah, we've learned the suspect is in a van. He has been apprehended. It was a peaceful arrest. He got out with his hands behind above his head and then behind his back. So suspect was in a van. Again, it's a man. We don't know what he was wanted for, but the right side of your screen is live pictures. The left is recorded video of the dangerous chase. If you're just joining us, we want to recap you on the very latest again. We have multiple crews following this breaking news, trying to figure out who the driver is and why police were after him in that white pickup. He eventually carjacked somebody in a similar looking car. Had we not seen the carjacking happen live on our air, it would have been extremely difficult to even understand that that was a different vehicle. So it makes you think, was he thinking, I need to get a similar vehicle to try to evade police again? But this right here is the end of that chase. That person right there has to be an officer now inspecting the car, likely going through it to see what was in it. But that is the car that it's tire blue on the driver's side. The front tire on the driver's side blew. The bumper fell off. That is what eventually brought this man to a stop. Right now, our big questions and what we're gonna work to learn throughout the rest of the day is, one, what was this man wanted for? Two, how is that man that he carjacked doing? And three, how is the officer doing that he hit as he was driving on this chase? He hit an officer in a cruiser. He didn't strike the officer itself, but he struck his car. So those are the three things we're going to work to learn. We are going to stick with this. We'll be back with more in just a bit. Again, this is breaking news of a police chase that lasted an hour, 20 minutes. Updates the rest of the day on KCTV 5 News. Right here at noon, we will be back with what we learn in just a bit.